Are you dancing? Okay, I'm getting the hell out of here. I went in that one, right? Wait, is there a second floor? What's this? Isru processor. New. 64% full, tank capacity. In situ resource utilization processor extracts hydrogen and oxygen from the soil for use as vehicle fuel or emergency water supply.
Your stuff's all military surplus, though. Makes me nervous having it in lockup.
I don't know. I didn't see this arrow. Hello.
I keep wondering what our scientists will cook up for Eos.
We came to explore and learn. That's who we are. Really hope all those scientists will be safe out here.
Henderson at the shuttle landing pad told me. He heard it from the pilot.
Izzy, you gotta stop listening to every rumor that comes in.
Okay, but when your shuttle gets eaten by space whales, don't say I didn't warn you.
She's pretty. Formal request for Darkat Tyrvian, number 28. Making the request again. Bradley, I know it's not your fault. Or making the request again, Bradley. I know it's not your fault. I know she's supposed to be second wave, but I want a trail so that when all this calms down in a few years, we can get proper outraged about how long it took to reunite families, especially ones hurt during the Site-1/2 mess. You know broken promise is a thing, right? Requesting the deployment of Darkat Tyrvian, W84 Crispin, Exo-Studies Specialist. Reason, she's an asset that will help viability. She's also my daughter. Oh, upload? Oh, this is like, what do you call it? From Mass Effect 3, when you could go on the terminal and pass through requests. The Spectre terminal, that's what I'm trying to think of. Okay. Uploaded. I'm just trying to help that get through. Oh. We're going this way. Oh. Got a merchant. Is this... This is glass. Yeah. I don't want to buy anything right now. Just... She doesn't speak. So... This terminal? Same thing? No messages. What about this one? Oh. Neither of them have any messages. That's weird. I'm getting frame rate hits. 38 frames. 46. 40. Oh, there's another floor. Go upstairs. You're working in the dark over there. I feel bad. I gotta get closer.
Hi.
Who's... Hi. Kane Forks. Technical equipment. Daedalus MK3 Fabricator. Caution, high temperature process, current cycle 3 hours 19 minutes. This fabricator produces nano-etched lenses which have multiple scientific and military applications. Well, in this case, it's going to be scientific.
You haven't got a fuel cell, have you? The quartermaster says there's plenty, but she would. Wait, oh, shit, you're the Pathfinder. Sorry, no one said VIPs were coming by.
I was never left.
I'm just Ryder. Nice to meet you.
It's... A pleasure to meet you, too. I'm Fox, chief engineer at your service.
Relax, Fox. Guy Fox. About Eos.
What do you think about your new home?
First impressions? We've got water, clear skies for solar power, plants to farm. The Remnant are a wild card. But I hear you almost have that solved, which is amazing.
Not really.
And you found us a good site here. I think Eos is really going to be special.
What made you decide to come to Andromeda?
What brought you all the way to Andromeda?
There's a colony back home you've never heard of. Viridis. It failed. Hard. I grew up there watching things fall apart. When I left, I got into infrastructure, civil engineering. Boring stuff unless you've ever lived without it. I wanted to do Viridis right, I guess. And the initiative was my best chance. Thanks for asking.
No problem. Do you have any colleagues, I guess? Or tell me about your colleagues, something?
What are the other outpost staff like?
Yeah.
Like Connor, you mean? She's pretty fun when you get to know her.
Sarah Connor?
Just don't get to know her over a poker game. Trust me.
What's your job here?
What do you do here?
My team gets things going. Water, power, communications, everything a civilization needs. Well, not laws or a constitution, but it's easier to concentrate on those when you got a flushing toilet.
Okay, see you later.
Bye, Fox.
Bye. Stay safe out there.
I'll try. Now, if I go back in...
Oh, you're back. Hi. Can I help you?
Hi.
Bye, Fox.
Bye.
Oh, didn't mean to do that. Okay, there's a terminal. Scratchpad. Login. Chief Engineer Kane Fox. This file is filled with sketches, annotations, and exploded schematic views. Many are focused on a combine road monorail network for Eos, showing several different but brilliant designs. Always good to go back to the old standby when I need to think. Underneath are several doodles showing elegant redesigns of the Nexus tram system map. Posted to, or pasted to one side, are a number of downloaded statistics on predicted population growth over the next century. Got a baseline. Bradley's always good for the numbers. Adjoining the statistics is a blocked out simplistic drawing of Prodromos, dotted lines showing expansion with detailed sketches of water and sewage lines underground, wireless power routers, and the flow of foot traffic. Sloppy, but it's a start. On the other side is a sketch of a Pathfinder helmet with downloaded notes on material testing and safety regulations. Design fundamentals look sound. No need to worry. Oh, it makes me feel better. Hey, from the Nexus. Fox. How is it there? I heard Bradley has things up and running smoothly. I knew you guys could do it. Tell me all about Eos. It's boring here, so I have to live vicariously through you. As for the advice you asked for, just be yourself. I know how you get when you're nervous. This special lady will like you a lot more if you just relax. You got this, buddy. Good luck. Ellis. Who's the special lady? Is it me? Special lady. Ask him who the special lady is.
Oh, you're back. Hi. Can I help you?
Bye, Fox.
Bye. Stay safe out there.
Alright. I'll leave you guys in your darkness. Okay, so that's that. So where did I come from? We are here. What's the question mark? Memory trigger. Oops. I'm probably gonna go in somewhere I've already been. Dr. Ramirez. Ramirez. Terminal. Victor Carson. Mr. Josephs, I find it troubling that you think I could be swayed from my duty by an offer of credits. I understand Victor Carson is a friend of yours, but that's hardly an adequate reason to release him from cryostasis and send him to Prodromos. Beyond that, from what I hear, you two are a disaster waiting to happen. I know all about the prank you and Mr. Carson pulled on Everett before the journey to Helios. Victor Carson will be released from stasis when I see fit and assigned to an outpost that best suits his skill set. And if I hear you've gone over my head and spoken to Addison about this, you'll have me to answer to. Administer Brecca. Case Notes, number 024, Dr. Ramirez. Symptoms and condition. Acute insomnia, claustrophobia. Details. On examination, no organic underlying cause. Apparently suffered a mechanical failure when coming out of stasis that locked her in the pod. Clearly a psychosomatic case, but symptoms are acute. Prescribed tetravoxine and VR post-stasis therapy. Next appointment in 2 weeks. Personal notes. I'm seeing several cases of post-stasis anxiety and other related conditions. The techies solved a lot of the physical effects of long-term stasis, but we're clearly seeing the psychological effects run a lot deeper. People just aren't designed to be turned off for too long. Should talk with Hainley about a long-term research initiative. We're at first for a lot of things. And case notes for number 076. Symptoms, condition, multiple leg fractures. Patient lost his grip and fell during maintenance work on the roof. Jump jets failed to fire. Compound fractures to the right leg, severe sprains to left ankle. Patient showed an allergic reaction to anesthetic, so I borrowed August and a couple engineers to hold 076 down while I set his legs. Ouch. Application of foam cast and appropriate analgesia followed. Huh. So he didn't know until now he was allergic to anesthetic? Personal notes. Noisy day, but hopefully an object lesson to the rest of the outpost about jump jet maintenance. Patient is healing nicely. Should be falling off roofs again in a week. I gotta talk to Ramirez in a second. What goes here? Hail. Ramirez.
August said you might swing by. Ryder, yes?
See.
Dr. Ramirez. Run the clinic here on Eos. Much better than life as an Alliance medic.
Good to meet you.
I'll guess you're not here for a checkup. How can I help you?
Tell me about your clinic.
What's the latest from your clinic?
Usual checkups for first-in colonies. Plus a few cases of dehydration and some blindness. Nothing serious.
What's life like on Eos?
What's it like living in our first successful outpost?
It's early days, but promising. Everyone pitches in, everyone matters. We know we'll make this work.
What made you decide to join the initiative?
Why did you join the Andromeda initiative?
Close.
I served in the Alliance as a medic, but let's say I saw one Batarian slave raid too many. I knew August, Bradley, and when he signed on to the initiative, suggested I consider it. This seemed like a better frontier.
And Bradley, is that one of the patients?
What do you think of Bradley?
I've known him for years. He was the squad medic when he was injured. And we kept in touch after his discharge. He's a smart fellow, a good lieutenant, but a better mayor. And it bugs him when I call him August. So I restrict myself to 2 or 3 times a day.
I'll leave you to it.
Come back anytime. Preferably unhurt.
Hmm. Don't you like your work? So one of these is August, I'm guessing? Carson. It doesn't say the names. No wonder I can't remember. Maybe this was August. Okay. Done in here, I guess.
Bradley, you shouldn't have bothered you with this.
Yet you do seem troubled.
My twin sister was at Site 1.
That's Bradley?
She was a genius. They still didn't make it. I keep wondering what I could do to help us that she couldn't.
Is this guy drunk? Or girl? Oh, memory.
Another eidetic trigger, Sam?
Yes, though my memory array remains locked. Additional triggers are required.
Here he is. August Bradley.
Mayor Bradley.
Pathfinder, good to see you. We're busy as anything, thanks to you. Bit dusty, but we can adapt. It's worth it when it's your own.
That's a pretty bad mustache there. Oh. Don't overwork yourselves.
Let's not drive people too hard. Rough enough getting this far.
Nothing you see here came from cracking a whip. Everyone is just ready.
That's
you
good.
Go do what you need to on the Nexus. Follow that dot. There will be more to do on Eos later. Some key positions: Connor Supply, Ramirez Medical, Abrams Science, Fawkes Engineering.
Okay.
With them and my major domo, we won't end up like Site 1 and 2.
Don't dismiss their efforts, I guess.
I combed the first 2 outpost attempts. Those people died trying.
And they deserved better from the Nexus. That's where I point the finger. We'll remember. You changed this planet, but that doesn't make it easy. We'll use the efforts of those who went before. Good people, every last one. I'd have been honored to fail with any of them.
Maybe there's hope for that? For you to fail with any of them? I don't think that's what she's saying, but it seems like it, yeah.
I haven't reached the end of that trail, but not everyone died outright.
Hmm.
Right. They tell me there were staggered evacs. If any want to try again, they're welcome. Oh, and Pathfinder, this is for you. It's our flag. Hang it where the Nexus can see. It's touched the soil of our first outpost in Andromeda. Make it real.
Head for the Nexus, Pathfinder. Prodromos will have more going on when you come back later.
Okay.
Nexus must be waiting, Pathfinder. Relax. There will be more for you on Eos after you get back.
What made you decide on this name?
What's behind naming the outpost Prodromos?
It means forerunner. Languages bore the shit out of me, but we voted fair.
Okay.
That ownership is key to the initiative. That's how you convince a bunch of civilians to jump galaxies. As long as we meet our obligations to the Nexus, what we build and how we organize, we get to figure it out.
Hmm. Tell me about your history.
Tell me about yourself.
August Bradley, retired from the Alliance. I keep the discipline, but not so much the doctrine. I joined the initiative because it's a frontier. Not a lot of those left. Not that you can reach on my pension, anyway.
Any family?
Hmm.
A niece on Earth. We didn't talk after my sister passed.
Sounds too familiar.
I've had similar happen to my family.
Yes, well, we stay out of people's grief.
Okay. Tell me about your people.
What can you say about the Prodromos block?
Exacting bunch, as the science types always are. We'll eventually allow the staking of claims for groups with enough startup resources. Not quite gold rush, not quite land grants. Honored to lead them for as long as they need me.
So we've both lost family.
My father, your sister. Sounds like we've both lost a lot.
We stay out of people's grief, Pathfinder.
What is that? Stay out of people's grief?
So I can't see her.
Shit, that's right. You didn't have the block leader death talk.
What?
The thing is, you and your father, not unique, just recent. Every initiative species, except maybe Asari and Krogan, went into cryo with friends and family and woke up knowing they were all dead.
Damn.
Everything we build begins with that. The unsaid start to the initiative. So yeah, we stay out of people's grief.
Paste in denial. How do you hold all that in?
How do you keep it from just spilling out?
I let it. And my people stay out of it when I do. And I stay out of theirs. What's that old saying? Children with dead parents think everything is possible and nothing is safe. That seems like it fits anyone in the initiative. Or maybe everyone.
That's sad. What do you think of Eos?
Just looking for a status report. Informal, of course.
Tell me about Eos.
Not much to report. We're making life up as we go.
Okay. Nexus leadership. What do you think of the leaders of Nexus, I guess?
Any insights about the people running the show from the Nexus?
I only work with Addison. She's by the book, and with all the shit that happened, that's to her credit.
And the others?
I only work with Addison.
Is that by design?
So your job doesn't require the others, or do you intentionally avoid them?
The initiative was smart enough to limit the obstacles between its people and jobs that need doing. Outposts deal with Addison. She deals with the others. And I don't envy her.
Alright, we'll see you later.
We'll talk another time.
Oh, and Pathfinder, what I said about grief? Every pirate we brought to this cluster woke up with the same reality you did. Maybe think about that when shooting doesn't have to start.
Now what happens if I stand here and a ship comes in? Death? Here I am! That's what I wanted to see. You can die that way. Now, did I talk to this guy yet? That's the only problem.
Nexus must be waiting, Pathfinder. Relax. There will be more for you on Eos after you get back.
Alright, we talked to him. Good.
We'll talk another time.
That's funny. Okay. That's what I wanted to see. We can get crushed by the shuttle. That's cool. Okay. Let me get this one. So you've been in there. Pretty sure. Cool. Oh, no, we haven't been here. Hainley Abrams. Yunsi Park. Let's check out the terminal first. Dictation log. Scientific Director Hainley Abrams. How? What technology can do this so quickly? Neutralizing the radiation in the atmosphere without dramatic storm effects? Shit, the opposite. I'm not used to cursing in these Let's Plays, guys. The weather's gone. calm as a summer's day. That's unprecedented control over atmospheric pressure, gas mixture, temperature, what else, and where's the interaction? Pause break. Miss the dogs. Walking them in the shuttleport park always helped me think through these problems. Forget side effects, too. I should get a dog. Are there dogs? Pause break. We got damn lucky with the conditions here. This is comparable to sea-level Earth. Eos is drier, but within limits. Moisture is binding into the desert plants and soil, more now since the vault. Points to a species with the same air, mixed temperature, gravitational comfort levels as us? Or is there another reason? Can't predict intent from results. Maybe Ryder's the one to figure out why. The how. That's my department now. Lucky old Hainley, you wanted bigger things. You've sure got them now. Research proposal submissions review. Materials analysis of recovered cat firearms. Approved. Important. Waterborne bacteria study. Approved, if you don't flush your work away. Color reactions and acuity in insectoid wildlife. What? No, not approved, unless you're going to make them stop at a red light. Comparison of quantum initialized string effects to relativistic waveforms. This is gibberish. I'm not giving grants for the best word salad. Element zero voltage research resistance testing. Finally, some real science. Approved. Well, she sounds like quite a character just from reading that. So let's talk to her and then this guy. Yunso Park?
Pathfinder? Mind giving me your opinion on this?
What's that?
I'm planning classes for our first school, when we have one.
Cool.
Some say we shouldn't teach Milky Way history. All irrelevant now, apparently.
No, it still matters.
We were all shaped by that history. Our children deserve to know how and why.
Absolutely.
Agreed. Maybe you'll change a few minds. Thanks for stopping.
No problem. And he's done. I can't select him now. Hainley Abrams. Sound like quite a character.
Ah, Pathfinder. I hear you're to thank for a physics-defying atmosphere processor.
That's me. I'm Ryder.
Me and my friends.
Hainley Abrams, Director of Scientific Research on EOS. And writer of papers that start what the hell weather. But new galaxy, new world, and a really new start. Gotta keep up. How can I help you?
How are the conditions on Eos?
Activating that vault changed the planet. Anything to worry about?
Considering it's world-altering technology we've never encountered before, I hope not. But the storms show no signs of returning, and I know who to contact for random tech support. I'll take it.
Cool. Tell me about your research.
What kind of research are you working on?
Your basic first in scientific work. Soil, water, atmospherics. Plus studying remnant tech, because now I need to understand that to survive here.
What do you think of, Mayor Bradley?
What do you make of Lieutenant Bradley?
Well, Lieutenant Bradley.
Determined as hell. And he has incredible faith in us to get this done. Bradley would carry this outpost on his back if he had to, and we'll make sure he never has to.
Yeah, that could be painful. So, what made you decide to join the initiative?
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
Back home, I was filling test tubes in some dead-end lab. People knew me as Stefan, but that was never who I was. I knew what I could do, and I knew who I wanted to do it as.
Cool.
Hainley Abrams, Andromeda Explorer. That's me. Feels good. Feels right.
Good for you.
Congratulations. Talk about a whole new life.
Thanks. Once my fiancé is out of stasis, it will be complete. When it's time, I'm hoping Bradley will perform our wedding ceremony.
That'd be awesome. Just curious if she says anything different.
What brought you out here to Andromeda?
Back home, I was filling test tubes in some dead-end lab. I knew what I could do. Hainley Abrams, Andromeda Explorer. That's me. Feels good. Feels right. Thanks. When it's time, I'm hoping Bradley will perform our wedding.
I've gotta go.
Keep up the good work.
Thanks. Oh, there's another entrance here, then.